The Electoral College. What is it anyway? I'm Anne-Marie.
I'm Janique.
We're going to be discussing this today with our guests Alfonso Rachel and Bill Whittle on this episode of
Politics.
There is an ongoing effort to destroy the Electoral College by which we elect the President of the United States. Conservatives think this would be a disaster. Let's find out why. Here with us today to talk about this complex issue is Bill Whittle. Also sitting in with us is Alfonso Rachel. Hi, guys.
Hey, guys. Good to be
Welcome.
Here.
Welcome.
This is confusing to a lot of people. The Electoral College, why we need it. Do we need it? Do we not need it? What's going on with it? And please, just first, what is it?
Well, the Electoral College is the system that we use to elect the President of the United States. Many people think that the President's elected by popular vote, but he's not. The President is elected by the states. The states elect the President. Each state has a vote. Each state is considered almost as a separate nation. And if somebody wins Florida by one vote, then all of Florida goes to that candidate. And so the states elect the President. And this is one of the many safeguards that are built into the Constitution to prevent power from accumulating in the federal government. All of this is designed to disperse power.
So we need it.
Yeah, I mean, you're right. But then how do you then challenge those that believe in the national popular vote? Because really, they've actually did a survey and they found that 75% of voters today think the way we elect our president should change. And there's even 7 states that have already approved the national popular vote bill. So what would you say to them then?
I say they're idiots. It's not their
really?
Fault.
No, well, you really say that.
Well, you gotta wonder, because if they're not listening to the Pledge of Allegiance that we're supposed to be saying, there is that part in there, you know, this republic, to this republic. Right. It doesn't say to this democracy of which it stands, it says to the republic.
So, well, can you explain the difference between republic and democracy? Because most people will say, but we're a democracy.
Right.
No, we're not a democracy. We're definitely a republic. And just like Bill is saying, if we have, and I'm concerned about this thing about fairness, because those who think that this is a democracy, they're so big on fairness. Well, if you take away the Electoral College, then, and Bill will explain this very clearly, you have taken away fairness. You know, we can't have this thing where it's 51 versus 50 and we have our president. When you have states that have only a certain amount of population versus another, if we try to do that, it's not going to turn out very good.
Can you explain?
Well, basically, this problem goes back to the beginning of America, where you had 13 colonies, and some of them were high population colonies like New York. And you had some with very small populations like Rhode Island and Delaware. Mm-hmm. And you're trying to form a union, and Rhode Island and Delaware says, well, why should we join this union? New York can outvote 5 of us together, right? All the big states are going to get what they want. Little states are going to get nothing. So to hell with you guys. Mm-hmm. So they had to figure out a way to be fair. They had to find a way to take care of the large population states who had more people and recognized that they had a majority of the votes, but you also had to protect the rights of the interests of the small states. And they did a bunch of this. So one reason you had 2 houses of Congress was that the Senate, up until the 17th Amendment, was supposed to be, the senators were supposed to have been determined by the states. Each state has 2 senators. So California, which is the most populous state in the Union, has 2 senators. I don't know, Rhode Island may be the least populous state. No, I guess it's Wyoming or North Dakota. They also have 2 senators. So North Dakota and California have the same number of senators, but they have largely different numbers of representatives in the House of Representatives. California has 50-something, and North Dakota probably has 2. Mm-hmm. Right? So you're trying to find a way to make both sides happy. The Electoral College is designed so that the President of the United States has to be elected by the entire country, not just geographically, but culturally, which means that in order to become president of the United States, you have to convince farm people in Iowa, and you have to convince urban people in New York. You have to convince both of them. If you eliminate the Electoral College, all the president has to do is campaign in New York, Los Angeles, Dallas, Chicago, Miami, and San Francisco, and he wins the popular election. He's president.
Yes,
he wins.
There's no diversity of appeal.
Yeah. Yeah.
The president, most people don't understand that this country spans an entire continent, and we are a tremendously diverse people. And the reason we accept this centralized rule from Washington is because the president has to appeal to all different geographical reasons. Mm. He has to go down to Alabama and he has to eat pickled pig's feet. He has to go to Iowa and he has to have roast corn. He has to go to New England. He has to eat the damn clam chowder. He has to do all of these things to show the people of this enormously diverse country that he represents all of us. And if you eliminate the Electoral College and just go with the popular vote, all he has to do is go to all the big cities, say the exact same thing to the exact same people, and he's president.
Now there's a threat to the Electoral College right now, correct?
Right.
What's going on with that?
Well, they're trying to abolish it for the same reasons that they're succeeding in everything else.
But
because no one is explaining the opposite side of the story.
Is it possible to do that?
To do
can
what?
Can they eliminate the Electoral?
They're
it
doing it. As you mentioned in the introduction,
seven states,
California, I think, was one of them, just recently said that the electoral votes of California, which is the single largest, it's 54 votes, it's something like that. It's fully a quarter of what you need to be president, if not more. Whoever wins the national popular election, California's electoral votes are going to go to that person. Mm-hmm. So it's basically giving up the entire idea of statehood, which suits Democrats very well. They want the idea of the states to go away. They want all of the power to be centralized in Washington, because then they'll be able to rule the country. Mm-hmm. The whole purpose of America as a republic was to take power, take it into the federal government, diverse it into the states, and then drop the rest of the power down to the people. Spread it out so that no one person can grab all of it and do the god-awful things that happened throughout history when one person has all the power.
Which is weird, because Democrats, they're so concerned about hoarding power.
Yeah.
But they give way to the very things that will cause that.
That's right.
Yes. Why is that? Why do they do that?
That's almost asking, like, you know, why does a moth bounce itself off a light bulb? It's, you know, we're getting down to the very nature. Well, really what they want to do is they want to facilitate their selfishness. Mm. They think that by doing these things, they will give power to a government that will satisfy their entitlement mentality and make way for their comforts. But they don't seem to understand that these things that they're going to vote for will basically, it's the fair distribution of misery. Mm. But by doing away with the Electoral College, and they think that they can get all these people to vote in what they want, this is what they think is going to satisfy them.
But some people raise the question when it comes to the Electoral College that it's unfair, especially when it comes to redistricting. And secondarily, some people also say, at least with the national popular vote, at least every vote counts.
Every vote does count. Mm-hmm. Every vote does count. Your vote in California counts. Mm-hmm. Now people will say, if you're a conservative in California, you might as well not vote because California is an extremely liberal state, but that's nonsense.
Oh, yeah.
Of course your vote counts.
It's horrible.
Your vote counts.
I'm ready to
And the battleground states are where these things are determined. But it means that the presidential candidate has to at least make an effort of trying to understand the various numbers of cultures that make up this country. And again, if you think about the difference between the people who live in San Francisco versus the people that live on the bayou in Louisiana versus the people that live on the very tip of Cape Cod versus the people that live in Southern California, people who live in the Corn Belt, the Bible Belt, the Rust Belt, these are vastly different countries.
Yeah.
Vastly different countries. And the only way people voluntarily give up their sovereignty to a government is if they feel that this government represents us. And more and more and more, this government doesn't represent us.
Sure.
Mm. Wow. So I think that some people, in their minds, the reason why they are probably more comfortable, I think you see a shift moving toward the national popular vote, is because most people can wrap their head around majority rule.
Yeah.
But for most people, they have a hard time explaining the Electoral College. I mean, you explain it phenomenally well, but not everyone can. And so I think that if there's confusion, then what happens?
The fundamental thing is what Zoe said. People do not understand that we live in a republic. You do not hear those words anymore. Oh, it's a democracy, 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 democracy. Democracy is an enormous benefit if it's constrained by rights. But the founders were terrified of democracy, terrified. Anybody who reads anything about the founders in the Constitutional Convention knows the one thing they were most afraid of is this idea of the mob just running loose and voting away everybody's rights. And if you're a member of a minority, you ought to be pulling hard for a republic, because you don't want to come to the day where people vote your rights away.
It's also constitutional, because it's Article 4, Section 4 that actually guarantees a republican form of government.
Thank you so much, guys. We want to thank Bill Whittle and Alfonso Rachel. Thank you so much. You guys have a great way of explaining what everyone needs to know. We want to we want you to come back and watch us again right here on Politichicks, The Right PC.